one in Monaco. That was a race that was not a Diamond League, and Warner was not there. He was second last week. And any design for Warner having that World Championship title next year, Olympic title the year after.
Well, he just got
Didn't
he just got a piece of bread?
Fastest time in the world. Chambers from Jamaica has the win of the Diamond League Series in Gateshead, and 31-year-old American veteran Angelo Taylor, two Olympic golds in the 400-meter hurdles. We also have a bronze medal in the flat 400 from the Osaka World Championship back in 2007. And Michael Bingham competed collegiately here in the United States at Wake Forest. He was second in the European Championships and fourth last week in London. And on the outside, the Irish record holder, David Gillett, twice a European indoor champion. Interesting last week in London, Jermaine Gonzalez, who will be out ahead as far as the stagger is concerned, got out to a big lead, and it took a lot of patience from Jeremy Warner. Do you expect a little bit more attention in the first 100 or 150 meters from Warner?
Yeah, he said, Warner said last week that he thought he gave away too much early, and he said he ran a stupid race. It actually looked pretty good to me because when he went by Gonzalez, it was a brilliant move, and Gonzalez had no answer. I do expect him, though, as you said, to keep a little bit tighter rein on Gonzalez's outside, who tends to run very fast in the first 250. Number one versus number two in the 400. Numbers one, two, and three, actually. Gonzalez, one, and two.
Air start for the bright blue in lane four. That's Gonzalez next to him in lane three on the inside of the stagger. That's Jeremy Warner in the bright green.
And it's actually the Ricardo Chambers, fourth of the left, who's going out very hard. But now look at Chambers. Chambers makes this move every race from right about 150 all the way to the middle of the turn. Look at him gapping now. Jeremy Warner, a lot of work to do in this 300 to 400 meters, 200 to 300 meter segment for Warner.
Jermaine Gonzalez with a big lead, maybe 3, 4, 5 meters, but here comes Jeremy Warner. Less than 100 meters to go. Warner holding his form, looking so relaxed, goes right past Jermaine Gonzalez and going to take his sixth Diamond League race of the year. And look at the time, a world-leading time of 44 and 14 100. And the former 400-meter king is starting to look very regal again there, Paul, because when he left his coach, Clyde Hart, in 2008 and then collapsed spectacularly off the home straightaway in Beijing, he corrected that mistake. He went back to Clyde Hart, and last year, when LeSean Merritt was really dominating him, I said, just wait until he has some more time on the Clyde Hart, and this performance, this looks like the Jeremy Warner that we're used to seeing, and now a huge psychological edge for him, because now Ricardo Chambers and these other younger guys who were thinking, he looks vulnerable, this guy is going to be hard to beat. So Jeremy Warner wins it once again, six straight wins at 400 meters. And look at this, as we said last week in London, Gonzalez almost got away, and it was 100 meters to go, and here came Warner once again.
The most impressive thing about this on your screen is the fact that Jeremy Warner seems to have gotten his finish back. That has been the suspect part of his race after being the most consistent part of his race for so many years. It doesn't matter how well Jermaine Gonzalez goes out, Warner has